a tremendous awards program and all of her hard work and effort, so I want to give her a round of applause. Yeah. Joanna was saying the other day, because she had a special birthday this year, and this is actually the 24th year presenting the Clapper Awards, and she was saying, I've been doing the Clapper Awards nearly half my life. So.
It's now, not so bad.
That's right. Now this year we're celebrating another huge event, which is Wadsworth's 200th birthday. And in honor of our bicentennial, we'd like to invite a special guest to the podium to kick off our event, and that's General Elijah Wadsworth.
Citizens of Wadsworth, I bring you greetings.
Is this working?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'll start over. Citizens of Wadsworth, I bring you greetings from 200 years ago. Now, I have been dead for 197 or 198 of those years, depending upon whom you ask. If you ask the people in the area around here, it's 197, but it took a little while for it to get back to the New England states. One of the things that I do today is to bring you the spirit of General Elijah Wadsworth, and I am he. And the reason I bring this spirit is that when I first set foot on this area, which is now called Wadsworth, of which I had five other people as investors, but I was the biggest investor, and as a result of that, the name Wadsworth was given to this community. But at that time, the only way that we could get news from one place to another was to have a town crier. And the town crier would go out and say whatever he had to say, and then another town crier would go beyond that and say whatever he had to say. And sometimes the news never got around the same way that it started from the very beginning. One of the things that has made me extremely happy as I look past this 200th anniversary is the fact that we have three people who have been able to do the town criering with such a finesse and with such aplomb that they deserve and need your acclamation. And that is John Madding over here, because he knows what to do with those buttons and everything else that he presses around here. And then we have Joanna Perino, who not only did this as a part of her responsibilities as the coordinator of activities in the WCTV studio, but she spent hours and hours and hours upon hours doing this so that everyone in Wadsworth would know what's going on. She has been a wonderful person to do all of the publicity for the 200th anniversary. And then we have John here, Quiet John. John Bernard, who has a lot of stuff. I would tell you what it is, but I don't know what it is, but a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff. So at this time, we start our 200th anniversary with the three town criers, John, and Joanna, the three J's.
Thank you, General. One of the things I want to mention too quick, too, we're talking about years and years and 24 years. 25 years ago, I started at WCTV, and at that time, a student came in the door named Brian Dodge, and Brian was the first student that, when I was here, got involved with WCTV, and he started doing our public meetings. He's actually doing a public meeting tonight, so he can't be here. He's doing the city council meeting tonight live. But Brian's been doing our public meetings for 25 years, so I want to give Brian a round of applause, too. Okay, now our first award is usually the last, but this year we wanted to crown the new host with the most first so that they can reign over our entire event tonight. The staff of WCTV selects the host with the most based on the three P's of being a good host: preparedness, presentation, and professionalism of their productions and the interviews they conduct. As always, we invite last year's winner, 2013 host with the most, John Grom, to the podium to crown this year's winner.
I thought we were doing it last again. I wasn't done eating yet. The day after last year's Clapper Awards, I got a phone call from my sister. And partway through the conversation, I mentioned the Clapper Awards. And then I had to tell, she's not easy to impress, but I tried. I said, I was given the award for the host with the most. She said, the most what? I said, I don't know. They didn't tell me. A couple of days later, I ran into a friend from church. We were talking about things, and I brought up the Clapper Awards, and I said, they gave me the award for the host with the most. He said, the most what? I said, I don't know. They didn't say. A few days later, my daughter called from New York, and I had to put it into the conversation somehow. I said, we had the Clapper Awards, and I won the award for the host with the most. She said, the most what? I said, damn it, I don't know. So this year, our recipient is going to figure this out very quickly because he is a lot smarter than I am. When you find out who this year's winner is, you'll agree this person really needs no introduction. This winner has produced well over 300 programs and conducted interviews with people of all ages, young and old, some very old, without even a note card. He's able to draw information from his guests and make them feel comfortable in telling the audience their life story. He also has a knack for never asking a question to which he does not know the answer. He has a wealth of knowledge of Wadsworth history, and his programs have enabled WCTV to record the oral history of Wadsworth for posterity. It is now my real delight and pleasure to pass my title on as the WCTV host with the most to this year's recipient.
Welcome to Wadsworth History on Film, a program presented by the Wadsworth Area Historical Society and designed to record the oral history of Wadsworth for posterity. We have a special program today for our 200th anniversary, and we're going to entitle it The Avenue of Queens, because we're going to have queens from 75 years ago up into the present day. John, the most what?
I have to crown you. I have to put your sash on. Face this way. There we go. You can get some chips, John. I didn't make you a hat because I knew you'd already have one on. Congratulations.
To those purists who ask me time and again tonight, you're eating with your hat on. I know you're supposed to take your hat off when you eat, but generals never take their hat off, nor do they ever smile.
All right, our next awards are our milestone awards. Our volunteers produce nearly 2,000 programs each year, and about 50 of them are series shows. So now we'd like to present our milestone awards to the producers of long-running series programs. The first one is their 100th show, produced of Light from Above, produced by David Kenney. And David Kenney actually produced his 100th show quite a while back, but it didn't air until January 3rd of this year. So David? And the winners of these milestone awards receive a little plaque with the engravement of the date and also the number of programs. On with our 200th show, the person who taped their 200th show on June 20th of this year was Steve Miracle, the producer of the Steve Miracle Show. And Steve is in Florida right now, but he sent us this short video.
By the way, do you know how much planning it takes to produce your 200th show? in Wadsworth's 200th year. Takes a lot of planning to make that happen. No, just mere coincidence that my 200th show comes in Wadsworth's 200th year.
Mwah!
Thank you, Steve. Okay, now we have somebody that produced their 300th show, produced by Robin House on April 4th of this year, Home Sense. I'm not sure if Robin's here. I didn't see her come in. So congratulations to Robin. The Philo T. Farnsworth Awards are presented by the Alliance for Community Media. This is a regional video competition encompassing six states. Every year we submit several entries, and this year our producers received three awards, including two first place winners. The students from the WHS Media Communications class won first place in the Best Performing Arts category for their production of The Sound of Music. Here's a short clip of their work.
Tea, a drink with jam and bread. That will bring us back to Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow. So, tea, a drink with jam and bread.
And accepting for the media class is Danielle Campbell and Ryan McCarthy.
Hi. I didn't really know I was going to say anything, but first of all, I'd like to thank our teacher, Mr. Barnett, for the both of us, and Zach Gosen, who could not be here tonight, sadly. Really, I mean, it was a lot of fun recording it. It was definitely an experience that I have never had before, and definitely something I really enjoy, and I'm sure Ryan could agree with that.
I do.
This is really like unbelievable. I mean, I'm very privileged, very proud to be accepting this award tonight, and thank you very much.
If we could have our second Philo Award winner is Andrew Reed. Andrew, if you want to come up. Andrew won first place in the best promo category for his Ride a Bike PSA. Let's take a look at his winning video right now.
Every year, 34 billion metric tons of carbon dioxide is emitted into the air. That's equivalent to the weight of 270 million blue whales. 13% of the emissions are due to motorized vehicles. As a human race, we need to do something to protect the planet we live on. You might think you're insignificant, that you couldn't possibly make a difference. The average American adds 17 metric tons of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere every year. 17,000 kilograms, 37,478 pounds. Still think you're insignificant? Cut down on your carbon footprint by riding a bike every once in a while. Take a ride to the grocery store, movie theater, coffee shop, or just ride for fun.
I would just like to thank my crew that worked on that. Mina Hoffman was the voiceover, Joey Phillips was the actor, and then also Media Communications and Mr. Barnett for helping me produce the video. So go ride a bike.
Our next Philo Award goes to Jeff Nicholas, and he is the producer of Discover Your Creativity and was awarded a finalist certificate in the Best Children's Programming category. I don't think Jeff's here tonight, but let's take a look at his video.
Something like that. I'm going to have a little bit of hair stand up here at the top, and then have a big piece of hair coming out this way, something like this. It's almost too neat for him. There's a mess. There's some hair for him. And we'll also bring some down from his forehead into the side of his head over there, and maybe a little bit like this. There's a sense of what Einstein may have looked like when his hair was a mess. When wasn't it a mess? I also read he never wore socks. He refused to wear socks.
Congratulations, Jeff. Okay, now on to our regular Clapper categories. In your program, you have on your table is a list of all the nominees, so you can follow along. The runner-up and honorable mention in each category will receive a framed certificate, and of course, the winner will receive the beautiful WCTV Clapper Awards. The first category is Best School Event, and the honorable mention goes to Valley View Talent Show, produced by Valley View School. Is someone here from Valley View? The runner-up goes to the Pumpkin Decorating Contest produced by Franklin School, and Roger Havens is accepting. Now we'll take a look at a video from the winner of the Clapper Award in the Best School Event. Veterans Day Program 2013, produced by Sacred Heart of Jesus School. Accepting is Bill Adams.
On behalf of Sacred Heart of Jesus School, I would like to thank WCTV, obviously, for airing our broadcasts. We really appreciate all the work that they do. One of the things that makes it quite easy is that honoring our veterans is a wonderful thing that we do every year. This past year, last week, we honored quite a few veterans with a breakfast and a program. It brings a smile to our faces and warmth to our heart. Thank all of our students and all of our parents who helped to make this program possible.
Our next category is Best Look Into Our Schools, and the honorable mention goes to Sacred Heart of Jesus Kindergarten 2013-2014, produced by Sacred Heart of Jesus School, and accepting is Bill Adams.
Oh, thank you very much.
The runner-up in the Best Look Into Our Schools category goes to Wadsworth City Schools, striving to be the best, the intergenerational technology, Dr. Andrew Hill and Paula Canterbury, producers. Okay. I think Dr. Hill had a meeting this evening. And now we'll take a look at the video for the Best Clapper and the Best Look Into Our Schools category. Survey Says, produced by Charles Berg and the WHS Speech 2 class.
Today, we are joined by my Speech 2 students, and they've created a show called Survey Says. And on this show, each student had to research a particular topic that they wanted to learn more about from the students at Wadsworth High School. They created survey information from it, and today they will be presenting it to you.
I surveyed a sample size of 20 Wadsworth High School students. The survey circled around the over-publicity that celebrities receive instead of what should really be publicized. The first question I asked was, do you think celebrities are overpublicized? And of those 20 students surveyed, 89% said yes. My next question was, who do you think is the most overpublicized celebrity? And 34% of those people said Miley Cyrus. Lastly, I asked, what do you think should be more publicized today? And an astounding amount of students said that issues going around in the United States and also around the world is what should be more publicized.
Interesting survey, though. Well done.
Charles Berg. He was here earlier. He must have had to leave early. So we'll go into the next category, which is Best School Performance. The honorable mention goes to Alice in Wonderland, produced by Medina County Homeschool Christian Co-op. The runner-up goes to The Little Mermaid, the WMS play, produced by Tim Yoder, Colin Wright, DJ Pettit, and Clint Sprunger. And Colin Wright's here to accept.
I have a pile for you. There's one for each of you.
And now we'll take a look at the video of the Best School Performance Clapper winner. Sacred Heart's 2013 Lip Dub, produced by the Sacred Heart of Jesus School. Accepted.
We had a lot of fun with that. I had Mrs. Clunan and Mrs. Pulte ask me if we were up to doing that, and I said, absolutely not. I was at the end of the school year, and I said, we don't have any time for that. And they said, please trust us. We'll get together on weekends, and they did a couple times. And then we actually did one rehearsal run through, and that was actually the second time we had done that, and everything came together, and our kids, as I said before, did a wonderful job. Sacred Heart has talent, and we're very, very proud of them.
You know, that's incredibly difficult to do in one camera shot like that, because I mean, you could do 10 rehearsals and be off and be in the wrong room during the wrong song at the wrong time, and you throw all the confetti and throw everything, you do it over, you gotta pick everything back up and throw it again. So that's a tremendous undertaking. Our next category is Best Student Production, and the honorable mention goes to Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, produced by the Media Communications class, and accepting is Danielle and Ryan again. And the runner-up goes to Thriller on the Square, produced by Tyler Kuntz. Tyler's not here this evening. Okay, now let's take a look at a video of the clapper for the Best Student Production. And that goes to AF2 Lego Designs, the Lego Movie Ticket Drawing, produced by Andrew Farmer.
Hi, welcome to AF2 Lego Designs. This is my co-host, Roger.
Hello, AF2. What are we doing today, man?
We have a special edition.
Sorry. I was a little early on the drum roll there.
Yes, you were. A special edition to draw the Lego tickets for Great Oak Cinemas Lego movie.
Yes, we do. We are giving away 12 total, right?
Yes.
Three four-packs. That's cool. And what comes with it? Are they just winning a ticket to see the movie?
No, they actually aren't.
On Saturday. February 8th. At what time?
1 o'clock.
1 o'clock in the afternoon. Now, that's the only time that this is a special admittance ticket, right? These are special tickets. So they're only good for that. So you win, you gotta show up for this drawing, for the showing, or they're no good. Right?
Yep. And you get, includes movie popcorn and a beverage.
Movie popcorn and a beverage. The big three, the trifecta.
Andrew Farmer.
I just want to thank Great Oak Cinemas for making it happen.
The last few categories that we've handed out have showcased programs either for kids or produced by kids. We encourage getting involved with WCTV at any age, but many of our producers begin in elementary or high school, and we hope they will continue into their adulthood. At this time, I'd like to invite Cora, Larkin, Raiden, Riley, and Kata to come up front. This group began this year on a new show produced by Georgette Thomas called Pay It Forward for Pets. They will forever be known as the Pet Panel as Georgette engages them in discussions relevant to caring for our pets. If you haven't had a chance to view it, please do so. It's educational, informative, and always funny. As you know, kids say the darndest things, and this group has really had some great TV moments. This is their first year on the show and their first Clapper Awards. We see a star quality in each one of them, and we'd like to give them something to use in their future productions or just to remind them that they're big stars. Great, thank you very much. Our next category is Best Documentary, and the honorable mention goes to Medical Mission to Honduras, produced by Cesar Carino and Chris Easton. Cesar, would you accept?
We've been dead for 100 years.
That's right, yeah. Our runner-up in the Best Documentary category goes to Bookin' 5K Run, produced by Tom Stugmeyer.
Bring me your camera so I can take your picture. Do a selfie.
Okay, I'll do that over there.
Okay, and now we'll take a look at the video for the best for the Clapper in the Best Documentary category. The Wadsworth Flyover, produced by Bob Parmalee.
Now we're coming up just about to the city limits of Wadsworth. And on the right, you can see the Franklin School building. And as we go a little farther here, you can see the railroad tracks where they cross at the south end of Wadsworth. And the match buildings, the old Ohio match buildings, are coming into view slightly on the left. Ohio injector buildings are on the right. And as we proceed up here a little bit, we'll see the Central Intermediate School, or for us old-timers, it's the old Wadsworth High School. Now we're crossing the square, and we're going north now on High Street.
Bob Parmalee. Now, I don't know, but I kind of get the feeling like he's hanging out with a camera over here, or he's sitting on the wing. Maybe you can explain kind of how you did that.
Well, we thank goodness for GoPro to come out, and we actually used a suction cup on the bottom of the wing of the airplane to hold it on there. So, but it was something I've wanted to do for a long time, doing a flyover of Wadsworth like that. And believe it or not, it's been on YouTube, and this year, because of the bicentennial, I've had 3,700 hits on YouTube.
Wow.
So many people commented, oh, gee, you flew over my house, and I saw my house, and some people said they hadn't been here for 20 years, and it brought back memories, and they were just glad to see it. So it was fun to do. Thank you.
Great.
Our next category is Best Religious Message, and the honorable mention goes to What Catholics Really Believe, produced by Tim Perry. Our runner-up in the Best Religious Message category goes to Light from Above, the New Testament Church and Prophecy, produced by David Kenney. Okay, and now we'll take a look at the video for the Clapper winner and the Best Religious Message. Goes to New Life Ministries, produced by Paul Blankenship and Josh McFarland.
But the Bible says that Jesus is the only way to heaven. Amen. He is the only way to God the Father, and that's through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let's look at verse 24 then. It says, being justified freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. So we have been justified. Again, like I said, our works cannot get us to God. Our works cannot get us to heaven. But because of Jesus, it says being justified freely by His grace. Now we are justified. We are cleansed. We are forgiven by His grace. God's riches at Christ's expense. Amen. Grace.
Paul Blankenship and Josh McFarland. The person down in the corner signing wasn't Paul, by the way. We didn't see him in the video.
Well, it was the first time we've ever done sign language in the studio.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So that was something we've never done before, and we decided for our Easter show, let's do something totally different to reach a group that's never been reached before by WCTV. So we got a whole community group in Akron who came out and did our sign language. What's interesting is we wasn't sure because this lady was due to have her baby any day who was doing our interpretation. So we could have wound up having a new host right there born in the studio. So.
Or another first.
That's right. Yeah, I was going to say that young lady, she was like out to here. So she was ready to have that baby pretty soon. But it was just a real blessing having her come on out and do the sign language for us. Paul does a great job. He puts in a lot of time putting all the videos and everything in the show together. And then I don't know about everybody that does a show here, but I got to say, whenever I come into tape, it's always real, it brightens my day to come in and see Joanne's smiling face behind that desk. And then, of course, John and John, all the hard work that they put in for WCTV. So I want to say a special thank you to the three of them today also, please, if we could have a clap for them. Oh, yeah. And she said, I better say amen. So Matthew McConaughey, he says, all right, all right, all right. I'm going to say amen, amen, amen.
Our next category is the Best Worship Service. And the honorable mention goes to Grace and Truth Church and accepting as Larry States. And the runner-up for the Best Worship Service goes to First Christian Church, produced by Bob Parmerly and Steve Thomas.
Congratulations.
You're
welcome.
Thank you. And now we'll take a look at the video for the Clapper Award winner and the best worship service. And that goes to Wadsworth United Methodist Church, the Contemporary Service.
Well, I'm going to begin this morning talking about the radical generosity of God. You know, our God is so, so generous. You know, if he were a human like one of us, we would just say he's, you know, off the charts, just, you know, crazy, ridiculous kind of generous. And, you know, probably the best known scripture, most well-known verse in scripture is that verse out of John 3:16, and it says, God so loved the world that he gave his life, you know, not just a little, not just, but he gave him his very self through his son. And so, you know, generosity is at the very core of God's being.
Is somebody here from Wadsworth Methodist Church? Nobody? Okay, we'll make sure they get that award. Our next category is Best Performing Arts, and the honorable mention goes to the 10 o'clock news produced by Virgil Mockel. Not here this evening? The runner-up goes to the University of Akron. The program is the University of Akron Steel Drum Band, produced by Bob Parmalee. And now we'll take a look at the video for the Clapper winner and Best Performing Arts. Grease, produced by Tricia Easton.
Take my ring, cause you're my match.
Well, I still think the string is attached.
Sure, it's in my epitaph.
Well, that's just a top of the half.
You're gonna make me die.
Don't make me laugh.
Well, I'll forgive what you put me through, cause I do believe you really love me too. I look in your eyes, the suffering does. I'm all choked up. Hey, 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 yeah. I'm all choked up. Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah. And is Tricia here? I don't believe so. Okay. Our next category is Best Public Awareness, and the honorable mention goes to Your Health and Wellness, Solving Senior Driving Issues, produced by Mark Grisco and the Visiting Nurse Service. You know, Mark's program, the subtitle was Solving Senior Driving Issues. And when I was kind of a naive 18-year-old, my freshman year in English Lit class at the University of Akron, my first paper I wrote, why when you turn 65, you should have your driver's license revoked. What I didn't understand is my professor was just about 65. I don't think I did too well in that paper. Our runner-up goes to Inside Wadsworth, produced and the subtitle Super Energy Heroes Camp, produced by Jim Kovacs, Andrew Farmer, and Lucas Keverkamp.
That's you.
And now we'll watch a video of the winner and the Best Public Awareness program. Your Tax Bill 2014, produced by Mike Kovac.
What we're going to do is take a little bit of time to go through your tax bill, explain some general questions, talk about some of the things that have gone over the last year that will affect your tax bill, and hopefully address some questions that you may have. So, first of all, Joan, you want to talk a little bit about the reappraisal that occurred last year? Actually, that was a good thing for most homeowners in the county, but
it was. Every 6 years, we go out and we reappraise all the properties in the county, and this tax bill is a result of that reappraisal. And I think overall the county values went down. And Mike will talk about that in a little while, that even though the values went down, doesn't necessarily that mean that your tax bill will go down in the same percentage. Yeah.
On average, across the county, residential values went down by about 4.5%. But that means, say within Wadsworth, I think values there went down maybe 6%. So if your property only went down 2%, you might have actually seen a small increase in your taxes. So it's your house compared to what everything else did. And if your house went down more than the 6%, then you would have a larger decrease in your taxes than perhaps some others.
And if Mike Kovac. Our next category is Best Promotional, and the honorable mention goes to In Good Company, the book and 5K run produced by the Wadsworth Public Library. And Melissa Wagner is here to accept. The runner-up for Best Promotional goes to the Ultimate Game Paintball Wadsworthopoly game produced by Roger Polk.
When are we getting our games, Tom?
All right.
Other way.
And now we'll take a look at the video for the Best Promotional Clapper winner. The Christian Man, produced by David R. Kenny.
Hi there, my name is David Kenny. I'm the host of the program Light From Above. I wanted to come and tell you about a series of special lessons we're going to have at the Church of Christ at 236 West Good Avenue here in Wadsworth, Ohio. The dates of our meeting are May 18th through May 22nd. Our guest speaker is Warren Kenny, my father. Let me tell you a little bit about him. He was born in 1944 in Monroe County, Ohio. Prior to turning the age of four, his father, George, died of cancer, leaving his mother, Hazel, to rear three boys. Through the influence of godly men, Christian men, which surrounded my father growing up, he would go on to marry my mother, Kay Kenny, from Westerville, Ohio, in 1965. My father graduated from the Nashville School of Preaching in May of 1970, and he's been preaching full-time ever since. My mother was stricken with multiple sclerosis when I was 15 years of age, and she is a constant support to my father and his work despite those obstacles. Think about the obstacles that they had to overcome. What held them together and helped them move forward? Well, come and hear about that.
David Kenny.
I just want to thank John, Joanna, and John, and the church at Wadsworth. And I really want to make mention of my parents. My father, many of you saw the story of the lady that took her life fighting a glioblastoma tumor. And my father has that same tumor. And so it's a very difficult time for our family, but my parents have taught me the importance of trusting in God. And I try to be a better Christian, a better man because of my parents. And I fall short, those shortcomings are my own. And I'm thankful for Jesus for making the difference. Thank you very much.
I know that all of our hearts and our prayers go out to David and his family at this time. The next category is the best special event, and the honorable mention goes to First Christian Preschool Graduation, produced by Bob Parmalee. The runner-up for Best Special Event goes to the Boy with the Leaky Boots statue dedication produced by Tom Stugmeyer.
Hold on.
You're just like Ellen.
I'm taking a selfie of us.
And now for the video for the best for the clapper in the best special event category. And that goes to Walking the Blue Tip Parade, produced by Roger Polk.
A 1904 Oldsmobile. Oh, yeah. Mayor, is that you?
That's me. I know you can recognize me in this.
Well, not from the back. No, you look like something out of Back to the Future 3. I thought it was Mary Steenburgen.
Way to go.
All right. Anytime Fitness, I'm going to shoot right in with them here. Oh, Clifford, the big red dog. I always wondered who cleans up after Clifford.
Oh, those kids.
Oh, my God. What's your name?
Connor.
Say hi, Connor.
Hi, Connor.
I'm on TV.
I'm on TV.
Woohoo! Oh, Twizzlers. Yeah. Got Twizzlers. Nice mustache. All right, who's with him? You just got dimed out.
Get me on TV.
You're on TV right now. Oh, yeah. 89. You are U.S. Merchant Marine. That's thank right. you for your service, sir.
Thank you.
Good deal.
Thank you.
All right.
Roger Polk.
Oh, thank you.
There are obviously the stars of the show. That is so much fun. I mean, you know, it's annoying with the sound going up and down, but everything I do is very annoying with my sound going up and down. Drives John nuts. But
how many years have you done that?
Oh, my gosh. It was your idea. How many years have we done Walking the Blue Tip?
A dozen.
Well, since, I mean, we started out with...
She was 10 then.
We start, yeah. Well, the funny thing is...
We were in the back of the high school. So
right.
It had to be before 99.
Yeah, it goes way back because my kids that are now taller than me and old, they were the little kids carrying the banners at first when we had them. Now they've all outgrown that, and nobody wants to be seen with Dad now. So, but we all know why, don't we? Thank you. Thank you, too. This is great.
Our next category is Best Sports and Recreation, and the honorable mention goes to WHS Swim Team Highlights 2013-2014, produced by Donna Kittle. The runner-up in the Best Sports and Recreation category goes to Grizzly Tough 2013-2014 WHS Girls Basketball Highlights, produced by Andrew Booth. Okay, and now for the video for the Best Sports and Recreation Clapper. And that goes to the Wadsworth Youth Football Tribute to Ralph Kennard, produced by Corey Uderbeck.
When I went to high school, I wanted to play, but I couldn't. I was just too small. And in my mind, every child that wanted to play needed a chance to play. Because I knew they'd feel like I did, and I didn't want that. So I decided from the beginning to play them all if it was possible. And we did. If you have an idea and you really believe that it should happen, the best way to do it is to roll up your sleeve and go at it. And whether it's rocks rolling down the mountain or trees falling on you, don't matter. You have to keep going. It's amazing. It's amazing. It is, really is. Can you imagine how I felt the morning that we met at the park? And I wanted 25 kids, and there was 197 kids. There ain't no way you could keep me from it. Somebody would have had to pay for that. All right. That I was going to play them all. and I did, and I hope they enjoyed it.
Corey? This program, by the way, received a perfect score from the judges.
I want to thank WCTV for quite an honor. Thank you. One thing just that I noticed kind of as we were going through the awards is everyone's motivated by something to create these works. And there's a passion behind all of what people do when they're creating videos like this for television or whatever outlet or forum in which they show them. And our inspiration was Ralph Kennard. And when I say our, I mean Wadsworth Youth Football. Two co-directors are here tonight, Rick Mooney and Brian Hall, who are friends of mine. And Ralph was the founder of Little League Football over 50 years ago. And I had the great privilege of interviewing him. And we used a lot of that for producing a tribute video for him. He was able to see that video at a special event in August. It was a wonderful evening. He and his whole family were there. There were about 300 people there as part of this event. And he passed just about a month or two after that. And I guess the message in that is that these things matter. It all matters. You know, when we do things that we're motivated to do, or for a passion that we have, and it touches people, and it makes a difference. And so I just want to congratulate all of the winners tonight for their fine work that they've done. Thank you.
Thank you. The next category is Best Instructional, and the honorable mention goes to RSVP, the Northeast Ohio Gardening Program, produced by the RSVP TV crew, and Phil Dell is here to accept. Is Phil still here? Yep.
And Sharon.
Oh, Sharon's here too? Yeah. Oh, okay, there's Sharon. And Natalie, Phil's wife, is back there. She's part of the crew as well.
Oh, that's okay. There you go. Congratulations.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
The runner-up for Best Instructional goes to Discover Your Creativity, The Bicentennial Bear, produced by Jeff Nicholas. And now for the video and the Best Instructional category, and that clapper goes to In Good Company, Easy Appetizer Recipes, produced by the Wadsworth Public Library.
Pesto in the little tiny jars they sell in the store is really expensive. And if you're a gardener and you've grown your own basil, there's really no reason for you not to be making pesto, because you'll see how easily this goes together, how quickly this goes together. The expensive ingredient are the pine nuts. This was a 4-ounce container, and I think it was $4.99 or something, or $3.99. It's a little crazy just how expensive pine nuts are, but then I don't know what's involved in acquiring pine nuts, so maybe it all makes sense. Anyway, 1/4 cup, and where I cheated a little bit today is this recipe recommended that they be toasted, and I didn't do that because I've made pesto before without having them toasted. I suspect the advantage might be that it would bring out some of the sweetness of the nut, but I don't think we're really harmed. So they go in the blender as well.
Melissa Wagner.
I guess just a quick thank you from Wadsworth Public Library. Janet Griffin did that before she left the library, so I guess a thank you to Janet for a great show. Thank you.
Our next category is Best Informational, and the honorable mention goes to Reality Check, What Our Schools Are Teaching, produced by Jeff Malik. I don't think Jeff was able to make it this evening. The runner-up for Best Informational goes to Unlocking Retirement, Market Watch, produced by Ben Schrock and Luke Busen. Okay, on with our video for the Clapper Award and Best Informational. And that award goes to Your Health and Wellness, Neurovascular Services, produced by Mark P. Grisco.
These are both vascular testings. Kathy currently is doing a carotid Doppler, so it's an extracranial ultrasound of some of the arteries in the neck. What we do is we scan the neck and look for any type of blockages. This would be useful in a patient with a bruit. It's a term used for a noise in the neck, so that's usually found through the doctor's office. It's also used and helpful for a stroke. Somebody with a history of cardiac problems, usually they'll have plaque in the arteries in the neck too. So what she does is she runs the probe up the neck and then listens to hear what's going on inside the artery.
So this is just for arteries, not veins?
Correct. Okay. These are arteries. Okay. The other is a transcranial Doppler. That's also done in this. It's also a vascular test, and it's an ultrasound of some of the arteries in the head.
Your health and wellness is a health show, and we try and get some health information out there to you in Wadsworth that we just find that we hope will be informational for you. There are so many people to thank when it comes to a show like this. One is the whole health facility over at Akron General allowing us to go into neurovascular that day. The other thing is, obviously, I'd like to thank our host here, Adam, who does a wonderful job quickly, and visiting nurse service for allowing us to do the show, and my wife, who has to put up with all the editing that I do. And for those of you who are out there who are doing the editing, you realize how much is involved with that. So, Adam?
Yeah, from what I hear, there's a lot of editing, too. So, you know, it's great work with Mark. We work together, visiting nurse, and he just makes it so fun. You know, me getting into this, I had no clue what to do, but he makes it easy. He does everything 110%, and you'd think he was a professional producer, so he makes it a good time. So, yeah, thanks, Mark, and thanks everybody.
Thank you.
Our next category, there's just a couple left, is Best Talk Show. The honorable mention goes to Wadsworth History on Film, The Avenue of Queens, produced by Cesar Carino. The runner-up for Best Talk Show goes to Your Health and Wellness, Osteoporosis, produced by Mark Grisco, the Visiting Nurse Service.
Next year, you'll notice it in front.
Thank you.
And now for the video of the Clapper winner in the Best Talk Show, and that goes to Right and Left, Discriminatory Profiling, produced by John Grom.
Between 1996 and 2010, there were 536,322 people stopped in New York for looking suspicious. Does that tell you that maybe profiling has gone a little too far?
Well, in the case of New York City, they had a real problem. And the problem was tourists were no longer coming to Times Square and coming to the city because they didn't feel safe.
Yeah.
And under, I believe, Mayor Giuliani, he doubled the police presence in Times Square. I've got a daughter that lives just outside of New York on the New Jersey side. And, you know, you go to Times Square and you feel very safe. The current mayor now has found this particular issue because of what they perceive as being profiling in a discriminatory manner. He's beginning to pull back the police presence there, and more of the problems that come up in large urban areas start mm-hmm. to crop up. There needs to be some effort made to make sure that when profiling is used, it's used in the right way.
John Grom. Our next and last Clapper category is Best Entertainment. And the honorable mention goes to The Ultimate Game, Paintball, produced by Roger Polk.
Mm-hmm.
And the runner-up is the Polka Time Again program, the LeBron James Special, produced by Gene Kovac and Joe Gabrosik.
Expecting a visit from LeBron after they did that show. They did get an invitation to be on the Ray Horner show in the, on the radio the next day, so that was nice. No LeBrons, though, for Gene and Joe.
Thank you.
Andrew's got them on.
And now for the Clapper winner in the Best Entertainment category goes to Mamma Mia, produced by Joey and AJ Hannah. Accepting is Sam Hanna.
So I didn't know that if I won, I would have to give a speech, so thank you, Alex. So I didn't really expect to win, because, you know, Alex was in it. And so thank you. All right.
Okay, now we will present, the last few years we've been presenting for awards for the most views on our streaming site, my.pegcentral.com. And this year, the Peg Central received over 21,000 views overall, and that's an increase of over 2,000 from last year. People are now watching full-length shows as opposed to just popping on to view a few minutes here and there. They're viewing from smartphones, tablets, and mobile devices, and they're now the preferred method of viewing. And we predict even more growth in the future. And the Golden Award is awarded to the program with the third most views on Peg Central. And this award goes to First Christian Church with 667 views. In second place, the winner of the Platinum Disc Award is the Medina County Homestead Exemption Show, produced by Medina County Auditor Mike Kovac, with 880 views. And the winner of the Diamond Disc Award with the most views on Peg Central over the past year, with 1,830 views, goes to Polka Time Again, produced by Gene Kovac and Joe Gabrosik. Just their 1,000th program that they produced, just that single program, had nearly 400 views itself.
I have to say one thing, Gene, about this is that with this program, getting up to the age where I am now, there are two things that keep me going.
The first one is playing my button box, and the second one is helping Gene produce the program.
Well, I didn't know we were going to be able to speak. I wanted to announce an event that was a landmark in my career. You know, my dear wife, Darlene, bought me an accordion 20 years ago and gave me my own practice room, the garage. This summer, Darlene moved my practice room to the basement, and our neighbor, whose patio faces our garage, sent over a bottle of wine and 24 roses.
Okay, we had some outstanding achievement awards this year that we gave away the director's chair that we awarded previously this year. And we have a video or a couple of pictures there. These director's chairs are presented to producers and volunteers who have had a long-time commitment to WCTV. Earlier in the year, we presented this award to two very deserving recipients, Paula Canterbury and Chris Easton. Paula had been a longtime producer and host of WCTV shows and retired from Wadsworth City Schools in June. Chris Easton also retired after serving the City of Wadsworth for over 30 years. He was a big supporter of WCTV. We appreciate the service that both Paula and Chris provided us over the years. Thank you. Okay, our final couple of things to take care of here. These are our Outstanding Service Awards. We have one last award to present, the Outstanding Service Awards. As we mentioned at the beginning of the presentation this year, Wadsworth celebrated its bicentennial, and that meant a year filled with speakers, tea parties, community events, dedications, band shows, book signings, fundraising events, carnivals, the time capsule opening, and so much more. More than we at WCTV had the manpower to cover. But thanks to these two people, we were able to capture every bicentennial memory for our viewers to see and to keep in our historical archives for years to come. We appreciate all the hours and hours of work that these two gentlemen have put into covering these events for us. So we'd like to present Bob Parmalee and Tom Stugmeyer with these two Outstanding Service Award WCTV crew coats. Thank you very much, guys. The 2014 WCTV Clapper Awards have come to an end. But before we go, I'd like to thank our production crew tonight, John Bernard for video here, our director in the truck, Todd Constantine in the cam van, and our volunteer tonight, James Bernard on camera. Thank you very much. We also wanted to update you on one of our former employees, Connor Polk. Since last year, Connor has graduated from Wadsworth High School and taken a new position with the United States Marine Corps. He recently graduated from boot camp and is currently stationed at Camp Lejeune in North Carolina for Marine combat training. Next, he will go on to military police school in Missouri. We are very proud of Connor and thank him for his service. Also, let's give a big round of applause for the team from Suprema Cafe and Windfall Industries for their delicious dinner. Come on out, guys. A special thanks to Kimberly for creating the Clapper cookie favors on your table, so don't forget to take them home with you. Thank you very much. It was awesome. There's also a magnet there, a my.pegcentral WCTV magnet you can stick on your car, and hopefully when we go around town, we'll see a lot of them on the back windshields of the car. We want to thank Craig Miracle for the Miracle from Miracle Custom Awards for preparing our awards tonight, Tom Stugmeyer for being our photographer this evening, and to all of you for coming this evening and supporting WCTV. Thank you very much for all your hard work and your effort this year. Thank you.